Welcome to the Foodie. I'm Kunal Vijayka. Food has become a passion for many, many people. And they've taken this passion and taken it to another level. Yes, I'm talking about bloggers who are also now doing very, very interesting things with food. Interesting things like walks. Yes, we're in Fort area in Mumbai and we're going on a food heritage walk. The guy's name is Kalyan Karmarkar. And he's taking me around the old parts of the city with a bunch of other people, and we're going to do a foodie fort walk. Fort being the old area of Mumbai. So come along, let's find Kalyan and the rest of the gang. Come on.
So I'm Kalyan and I'm a food blogger, and I've been blogging for the last 6 years, and I'm also a market research professional. So today on the food walk, we've invited Kunal, and he loves food. And we are going to Fort, which is one of my favorite places. And we're really looking forward to eating with him.
Today is an exciting day. First, I'll be meeting a few friends at Bombay Store. Hello, how are you?
Hey, hi Kunal.
Hi Kalyan, how are you?
Good.
Hi.
This is Vipul.
Vipul.
Manisha.
Hi Manisha.
Samir.
Samir, hi.
Rishabh.
Rishabh.
And that's Jyotika.
Jyotika. And this man over here, I have to introduce him, he's Kalyan Karmarkar. He's passionate about food, and not only that, he's taken this passion to another level. You're actually spreading your passion around, aren't
you? Yeah, yeah, yeah. The idea has been to like share about all the places which one has found about, and it's been great fun like connecting with people who love food and
So what happens over here? You invite people over through your blog.
That's right.
Yeah?
That's right.
Which is called Finely Chopped.
That's right.
And then you meet in Bombay Store, and then you take them around the old part of the city, which is a fantastic idea. And are you guys looking forward to walking, first of all, walking?
Walking for the food.
Walking for the food, okay. What is the agenda for today?
Well, we are at Fort, and I just love, this is one of my favorite spots in Bombay. So we're going to try out like a diverse part of Fort. So we're going to have street food. We are going to go to some restaurants which have been here for more than like 50 years or so. Some which are there from before the time of independence, and we are going to try like a plethora of food, which is what Fort is all about. It's going to be like one long 4 hour long buffet.
This is very exciting. Chalo, I think whetted my appetite. I think you whetted everybody's appetite over here. I bet you guys are also hungry. Like one scout camp, shall we?
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, come on, let's go. Let's go. Which is the first place we're heading to?
First place which we're heading to is Yazdani.
Yazdani Bakery?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Which is on Kawasji Patel Street on the left.
I love this building. This is a Gujarati thing. But the architecture is certainly very different. Like you have all this Parsi thing.
Oh, okay.
This is more like a Gujarati Hindu sort of architecture, which is very different. And even the pink stands out.
Okay, so where are we now?
Yazdani is up there.
Okay, Yazdani is up there.
Yeah.
Right. And this is also a really old part of the city, is it?
Yeah, it is. And Yazdani is 60 years old. Huh. And it's actually based on a Japanese pagoda. So if you see the architecture from outside, it actually looks like a Japanese temple and a pagoda.
You're
and
right, it does, huh?
It is. And that's how it was built.
This is very, very exciting. And if you look around, you can see there is so much of bread and all the wonderful things that come out of a hot bakery.
So come guys, we'll see the bakery, which is like really fascinating in Yazdani. So this is, look at the sacks of flowers over here. So all of this is going to become your brun, your pao, your ginger biscuits, your breakfast teas and everything's over here. These are the trays in which the bread is made. These apple pies will match with the best of Europe, and this is where it's being made. So it's and this is, look at these dinner rolls over here. So this has already been baked. So this oven, which is an electric one, is where the biscuits are made.
Okay.
So you've heard of the famous khari biscuits and so on. So this is the famous Parsi khari biscuit.
The biscuits are all made over here in this oven. That is the oven for the bread.
Look at this. See how deep this is. So all the famous pav of the Bombay, vada pav, pav bhaji, keema pav, all the pav is made over here.
Okay, don't talk pav, let's eat some pav. Come on, let's go.
So sab chai sabke liye aur brun maska aur ban maska aur thoda khari biscuit. Well, before there were coffee shops, this is what Bombay was about. Mumbai was about the Irani cafes, and people would come here for their chai, for their ban maska and their brun pav and curry biscuit. And the drill there was that you eat and you go. You don't sit there, and they would have all these boards which would say no reading the newspaper, no talking to the cashier, no petting the cat, no combing your hair. And it's such a big part of the heritage of Mumbai.
This is actually deeply ingrained in Bombay's food culture, yeah. And I'm really proud of the fact that you don't have Irani cafes anywhere else in outside Bombay.
Chacha, thank you. Okay, my chai is around, but that table still needs some chai. So, but listen, guys, if you don't mind, we are going to start with our chai, okay?
And I don't know if you guys knew, but the brun pav is a big favorite of the Parsi grannies. So, because they're all toothless, and they take this hard, crusty bread and dip it in chai. And it's greatly enabling for someone who doesn't have her teeth to have something so crusty.
I need to show you this. This is so full of butter. Yeah, look at this. It's just butter, butter, and more butter. You're not on any sort of diet when you're here. You just want to enjoy yourself. Whether it is a brun or whether it is a curry, dip, dip, dip. Are you guys enjoying yourselves? Happy? Good way to start the morning?
Okay.
Superb. Jam over here.
Guys, now we head for lassi with malai. So this is the ustad who makes the lassi.
Oh, this is the ustad?
Yeah, every time when I come here, he's the one who makes a lassi.
Namaste ji.
I discovered it by chance and it's the most best lassi. You get many versions, mango, yeah. Special, sweet, chhas, and this thing. I always go for the special, which has this thick layer of malai.
I will go for exactly that.
Cheers!
Here we go. Oh, look at this. Not only is the lassi thick and creamy, there's this whole layer of malai on top of this. Oh my God.
And it's guaranteed to give you a milk mustache.
Yeah. Look at this, look at this, look at this, look at this! I'm intrigued. Never heard of moti lassi. I might have missed out on something so incredibly delicious if it wasn't for this walk.